Hopefully we all remember our good friend the chain rule from differential calculus that tells us if I were to take the derivative with respect to x of g of f of x, g of, let me write those parentheses a little bit closer, g of f of x, g of f of x, that this is just going to be equal to the derivative of g with respect to f of x. So we could write that as g prime of f of x, g prime of f of x, times the derivative of f with respect to x, times f prime of x. And if you want to see it in the other notation, I guess you could say, it would be, you could write this part right over here as the derivative of g with respect to f times the derivative of f, the derivative of f with respect to x, and then that's going to give you the derivative of g with respect to x. This is just a review. This is the chain rule that you remember from, or hopefully remember, from differential calculus. It's hard to get too far in calculus without really grokking, really understanding the chain rule. So what I want to do here is, well, if this is true, then can't we go the other way around? If I wanted to take the integral of this, if I wanted to take the integral of g prime of f of x, g prime of f of x times f prime of x dx, well, this should just be equal to g of f of x, g of f of x, and of course, whenever I'm taking an indefinite integral, g of f of x, so I just swap sides, I'm going the other way. So if I'm taking the indefinite integral, wouldn't it just be equal to this? And of course, I can't forget that I could have a constant here now that might have been introduced, because if I take the derivative, the constant disappears. And so this idea, you could really just call the reverse chain rule. The reverse chain rule, which is essentially, or it's exactly what we did with u substitution. We just did it a little bit more methodically with u substitution, and we'll see that in a second. But before we see how u substitution relates to what I just wrote down here, let's actually apply it and see where it's useful. And this is really a way of doing u substitution without having to do u substitution, or doing u substitution in your head, or doing u substitution-like problems a little bit faster. So let me give you an example. So let's say that we had, and I'm going to color code it so it jumps out at you a little bit more. Let's say that we had sine of x, and I'm going to write it this way. I could write it. So let's say sine of x squared, and obviously the typical convention would be to put the squared right over here, but I'm going to write it like this, and I think you might be able to guess why. Sine of x squared times cosine of x. Times cosine of x. Times cosine of x. So I encourage you to pause this video and think about, does it meet this pattern here? And if so, what is this indefinite integral going to be? Well, let's think about it. If f of x is sine of x, what's the derivative of that? What's f prime of x? Well, f prime of x in that circumstance is going to be cosine of x. And what is g? Well, g is whatever you input into g squared. So what's this going to be if we just do the reverse chain rule? Well, this is going to be, well, we take, oh, sorry, g prime is taking whatever this thing is squared. So g is going to be the antiderivative of that. So it's going to be taking something to the third power and dividing, and then dividing it by 3. So let's do that. So if we essentially take the antiderivative here with respect to sine of x instead of with respect to x, you're going to get sine of x to the third power over 3, and then of course you have the plus c. And if you don't believe this, just take the derivative of this. You'll have to employ the chain rule and you will get exactly this. And you say, well, what? How does this relate to u substitution? Well, in u substitution, you would have set u equals sine of x, then du would have been cosine of x dx. And actually, let me just do that. That actually might clear things up a little bit. You would set this to be u, and then this all of this business right over here would then be du, and then you would have the integral. You would have the integral u squared. I don't have to put parentheses around it. u squared du. Well, let me do that in that orange color. U squared du. Well, that's pretty straightforward. This is going to be equal to u. This is going to be equal to u to the third power over 3 plus c, which is equal to what? Well, we just said u is equal to sine of x. You reverse substitute, and you're going to get exactly that right over here. So when we talk about the reverse chain rule, it's essentially just doing u substitution in our head. So in the next few examples, I will do exactly that.